What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Tamra. If you are new here, thank you so much for stopping by. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I will be really, really happy to have you. Today's video is going to be on this green smoky eye. Didn't really intend for it to be this smoky, but I love her. She turned out so cute. Faces beat, highlight popping, lipstick popping. And if you want to see how I got this look, go ahead and keep on watching. Well, it has been a minute. I don't even know what I'm doing today. I just know I want to play in some color. I have like way too much going on right here. I have three, technically four, I don't know if I'm gonna use this one yet, but four palettes in front of me because I don't know which one on my heels. I want to do something with green. I'm gonna go with the Mineralized palette, and now I need a napkin to wipe this off. The other palette, I think I'm gonna use this burgundy shade that's in here because it's just really pretty. Y'all, I hope this turn out cute, because if it doesn't, put a joystick. All right, so I'm gonna take the Morphe 350 palette and I'm gonna go in with this top middle shade here. It's just like a crease color. I'm gonna use just to have something to blend my actual crease color into. Just kind of diffuse it a little bit. It's pretty much my skin tone, but it just acts as like a buffer. At least for me, so that things don't get too messy. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this burgundy color from this Suva Beauty palette. I've never actually heard of Suva Beauty, but I got this in a beauty BoxyCharm box a while ago. So yeah, this color is called Aesthetic. It's just a burgundy color. Any burgundy color you have should work, girl. Just make it do what it does. And I'm gonna go straight into my crease with that, like looking straight ahead, smack dab into my crease. And I'm gonna concentrate right there so that I don't blend it out too high. And just work that back and forth, windshield wiper motions, girl. This might actually be a little bit darker than what I was going for, but we're still gonna use it because we're already here. So, just buffing that out, not taking it up too high, making sure that I focus on the edges. And because it's too dark, I'm gonna switch and use this burgundy shade in the Through My Eyes palette. It's called Misbehave. It's just a little bit more pink and it'll just kind of brighten up the crease a little bit. I didn't want this to be too smoky. It's fall, you know, we're not into the deep winter eye looks yet, at least I'm not. I'm just kind of adding this to the outer portion. I'm just blending. All right, so now we're gonna go in with Moody, I think it's called, yeah. Moody, this is just a flat shader brush. And I'm gonna pick that color up, tap off the excess so we don't make a mess. And I'm gonna just pack, ooh, that's so pretty. Pack this onto my lid. Whole lid area. Would have did well to use a smaller brush. This one is huge. I'm gonna take that same brush that I was blending out my crease with and just buff that green into it. Oh, this is really pretty. So we finished the whole faces. This screams, I'm going to get some hookah in the middle of the day with my girlfriends, you know. Saba, hey. And I just lightly blended out the edges of that so that it doesn't just have like a sloppy cut crease type of look. And now because I blended out, I'm gonna just pack some more shadow on top to intensify the color, because when you blend stuff out, you wash away some of that color. Okay, and that's it. Now we just gotta clean up all of this fallout. I absolutely hate fallout, which is why I never do my foundation first. But we're gonna clean this up and come back and finish the rest of the face. Okay, so pro tip, put a little bit of lotion on a cotton pad or something, or a Q-tip, and use that to help clean up your makeup fallout. I like doing this instead of wasting like a whole wake up wipe. Instead of wasting an entire makeup wipe, I like doing this instead. And it helps moisturize the under eye area. Like, you can't really go wrong with it. Okay, so I just applied my lashes. I used the Ardell Wispy Double 113. It's just like another version of their Double Wispy lashes. People don't really like Ardell lashes, but I like them because they're good for like everyday simple looks. Like, when you're not trying to be too extra, but you're not trying to be too, you know, boring. This eye is always giving. And my tear ducts are so like active that it's just not the move. So we're not gonna worry about that. We're gonna do the rest of our face. I've already primed with the Silk Canvas primer before I put my lashes on. That way it had a chance to like seep into my skin. I'm gonna use my Smashbox foundation. This is the 15 hour hydrating foundation in the color 4.25, and I'm gonna just start to blend that baby in. I'm very aware that it's a lot darker than me, but I don't necessarily want my foundation to be my exact shade. I like it to be a little bit warmer so that I don't look ashy, especially when I take pictures. And as long as it doesn't oxidize down too dark, I'm usually okay. And in this case, get foundation in my hair. In this case, it oxidizes just perfectly. So we good. All right, so next I'm going to conceal. I'm gonna use two concealers today. The Fenty concealer in 360 is a lot lighter, and this is the 415 Honey L'Oreal Infallible that I always use. I'm gonna go in with the L'Oreal one first, and this is going to look like a lot. Don't come for me, but do what I want. Okay, so while that kind of settles into my skin, let's see what the heck this lash talking about. She wanted to behave today. Thank you, Jesus. All right, so I'm gonna take my sponge and slowly start to buff that in. I just love this concealer. Like, it just blends out so easily compared to the other concealers I have and a lot of other concealers I've tried and didn't like. It just blends out like so smooth and perfect. We're not done, clearly, but I love it for that. And it has great coverage. It does not crease. It's beautiful. And it's only like $10. Makes it even more beautiful. All right, and for a little bit of brightness, I'm gonna take the 360 from Fenty just a little bit. Right underneath my eye. I'm gonna let that sit just for a second. Let it dry down, you know. If you don't know the purpose of letting your foundation, I mean your concealer dry down, it's just to help it blend better. When it's wet and it doesn't start to settle, it just kind of moves everywhere. If you let it sit for a little while and then start to blend it out, it already started to adhere to your skin, so it just applies a whole lot better. Okay sis, take my sponge and I'm gonna kind of concentrate that right under my eye. I don't want to blend it out too much, or blend it out too wide, I should say. And then I'm gonna take my foundation brush, like always, and blend out the outer edges of my concealer here, just so that it kind of seamlessly blends into my foundation. No harsh lines. I think we're looking a little bit like money, just a little bit. I'm gonna take this brush here and just kind of clean up. All right. Okay, now that we're all concealed and everything, it's time to set. I'm gonna use one setting powder today. We see how we like that. I'm gonna use the Fenty Beauty, what is this called? Retouch setting powder in the shade Cashew. And I'm going to use it on a little fluffy brush. Just gonna pat that, get the excess off the back of my hand, and just push that directly into my under eye. Just setting this first before I go in and try to bake anything. That way we don't bake any creases, you know. It's just, I just like doing it this way better. It just looks 10 times better and it lasts. It's not clumpy, cakey, none of that. So we just push it in to our skin. Look, oh, if Fenty Beauty did anything right, it was these powders. Okay, and before I go in with some bronzer and blush, I'm gonna set the rest of my face using my MAC Studio Fix in Dark Deepest. Just to help make sure that foundation does not go anywhere, doesn't start separating too quickly, mattify our skin, all that. The bronzer and blush, I'm gonna be using the Hoola Toasted Bronzer and the Makeup Revolution matte blush powder in the color Nude on a big fluffy Real Techniques brush. Why can't I say brush today? Gosh, I've said like blush three times. I'm gonna go straight into that cheekbone area. It's just so pretty. It's just like the perfect color for me. I know there are others on the market, I know, but this one I love. Okay, blush, I'm gonna use the same brush and just warm up those cheeks. I'm kind of feeling this like matte look. I don't know if I want to add highlighter. Ooh, do we want to add highlight to this? I don't know. Let's set our under eye. I mean, let's finish our under eye area and then we'll decide. I'm just gonna press a little bit of powder under here to kind of catch that fallout that we are about to have. Black eyeliner, and I'm gonna line the outer portion of my waterline. And then I am going to take that green shade that we used. If I can find it. Oh, I'm gonna take this green shadow that we used on a short shader brush and just smudge out that black and kind of connect it to the top, to our shadow on our eyelids. Ooh, we are so smoky and so dark. Remember when I said I didn't want the eye look to be like super dark because we ain't deep into this. This is dark. I don't know what I was, what was I saying? And then I'm gonna go into the burgundy color, same brush, and just kind of add a little bit of that. So basically the same thing that we did on the top, we do on the bottom. How far you bring it down, your prerogative, sis. I don't really want mine that far down, so we're gonna stop while we ahead, okay? Okay, so now we're gonna set the face. This is my Morphe continuous setting mist. Love that stuff. It just makes your skin come back to life. I'm gonna add some mascara to the tops and bottoms of our lashes so that our natural lash blends in with our falsies, and so that you know, that shadow that's on our lashes, you can't see that. Ooh, waterworks. All right, and lastly, I think, because I still haven't decided if I want to do highlighter yet, but for lips, I'm gonna take my ColourPop BFF4 lip liner. And I know I didn't want to do gloss, so but I didn't really want to do a matte lip either. Like, I didn't want to, not in a dry lip mood today. So I chose my Maybelline Touchable Taupe drugstore goodie. Nah, I'm gonna add highlighter. Where's it at? All right, I'm using Fenty Beauty Hustle Baby. I'm just gonna pop that right onto the high points. Oh yeah. How could I not want to use highlighter? What the heck? Girl, get it together. Get it together. All right, y'all, that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I really like how she turned out. She's ready for a lunch date with her friends, with her man, whoever. You know, she's cute, she's dark, she's smoky, she's fall. I knew I wanted to use green, but I just didn't feel like it would be this smoky of a look, but I love how smoky it came out. Like, she's here, okay, honey, snapped. I'm really excited to play with a lot of fall colors this year, so look out for more videos. If you enjoyed this one, please give it a thumbs up. Share this video with someone you love, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.